So, about maybe 45 minutes after I left the store, after I left Target, I get a text message from an unknown number. Lo and behold, it's Mr. Peter. And I say Mr. Peter because he called me Mr. Eric. And I later on found out that one of his coworkers actually like convinced him to send me a text, to shoot me a text, or at least so he said. But I was excited to hear from Peter. I made plans to come back at the end of his shift, and I asked him if I could walk him home. And he said, sure. So I came back to Target a couple hours later, 9, 10 o'clock when they closed. I want to say it was maybe 9 o'clock. It was dark. I do remember that. And I remember waiting for him to come out of the store. And when he first came out, I did not recognize him because this is the first time I saw him without a mask. And I realized that he had a beard and he was much more attractive than even I originally thought. And I remember one of the first things I said to him was like, oh wow, if I knew that you had a beard, I don't know if I would have been as confident to approach you. And so off we go. And I can only describe the walk back to his apartment as butterflies and cloud nine and magic. It is worth mentioning at this point that before Peter and before, and this is still coming, so it's not yet, but I have never loved a man. I have never come close to dating a man. Maybe a little, maybe kind of close, but it never felt right like this. The best way I know how to describe dating in the gay world is kind of like two moving ships, and you just have to catch the right current. You have to be passing by the right ship at the right time, at the right season, at the right wind, because I hate to say this, it does not bring me any pleasure to say this, but most members of the gay community, specifically the gay community, will tell you that when you meet a new gay person, it does not bring me any satisfaction to say this, but it's like there's this running joke that it's like, oh, are we gonna hate each other or are we gonna hook up, right? No, in between. It's either we find each other mutually attractive and we do our thing, and then I block you, or I hate you right off the bat, and then I block you. Again, I'm exaggerating a little bit, but not too much. So, due to the way that I had approached Peter and the dynamic that we had, it became obvious that, or very obvious right off the bat, that both of us were looking for something more serious. Ironically enough, Peter's boyfriend, ex-boyfriend, and I have the same name. So I found out that quickly, pretty early on. And I remember telling him, like, well, I'm different. I'm not that Eric. But it was just really, really hardcore flirting. So we walked from downtown San Francisco to a neighborhood known as the East Cut. So East Cut, South Beach area in the Embarcadero of San Francisco. Good mile and a half walk. And we were flirting, we were grabbing each other, we were kissing. And there's a part of me that realizes that that's a privilege that people don't have, not even across the United States, and that how lucky I am to live in a city like San Francisco where I can freely express my love, mind you, at 9 o'clock at night and not have to worry that I might get killed or that we might get beat up because of our attraction to each other. I also remember kind of making a joke where my family's been in San Francisco a while. Actually, on my dad's side, we go all the way back to the Gold Rush. I remember making a joke about, and it wasn't probably gonna happen because of how late it was and because of the neighborhood that we were in, but I was like, oh my God, like what if one of my tias drives by and sees me? And we got to, you know, we asked all the basic questions like, where do we come from, our families, and I'll get to those in the next video. But I remember that we both had a mutually decided that I was only going to walk him to his front door, and that's totally fine. I was not trying to have sex with him. As a matter of fact, I knew that this was something that I wanted to pursue and someone I wanted to be more serious with. If anything, just based off of what I knew about him up until that point, I truly did feel like it was my turn. I felt like I had found my person, and I felt like this was the missing ingredient, if you will, to the special surprise announce, not surprise, but the huge announcement that I was getting ready to make in just a few months. And you'll see what I mean by that shortly. So again, I remember we get to the front of his apartment complex. And actually, let me just throw in there that when we were first texting back and forth, making the arrangements to meet up, and I'll be honest, I was very persistent about wanting to walk him back home after work. And he kind of threw out there like, oh, like kind of what's the rush? Like, do you not live here? And I assumed that he did not live here because San Francisco is an insanely expensive city. If you're like later 20s, right? Or however old I assume this guy was, again, later 20s, you either work in tech or like you're like a master's or college student, you know, like a graduate student. You're not, that is, there's really no in between. I hate to say that about San Francisco, but it's the truth. It's not a working class city. It's not a city where young people can come and find themselves. That's not the case. So I automatically assumed that he did not live here, that he probably lived in the East Bay somewhere. So that further impressed me that he did in fact live here. And I was intrigued. I was like, really? I said, so you figured something out. Good for you. That impressed me. I was even more impressed when I found out that actually he had moved here on a whim, not necessarily with a plan, and had actually worked out and figured out a pretty nice situation for himself. But I'm getting ahead of myself. So the way that we ended that night, lots of kisses, lots of butterflies, lots of, I don't know, gleeful boyfriend talk, is that I left him at his front gate and we made plans to meet the next day at Dolores Park. And one of the last things that he said to me was, I really hope you don't ghost me. He said, please don't ghost. I hope I see you tomorrow. So I said, you will. I said, we're gonna meet up tomorrow, I promise. And that was that. I left him, I let him go over to his unit, and I was ready to like explode from the outside. I was just so happy and so grateful, and I felt I had met my Prince Charming. So I'll tell you more about the next day and how that went and everything else that I found out about Peter in the next video.